Hello everyone, you're watching Delhi Knowledge Track and this is Chandrajyoti Singh, AIR28. I'm here to discuss my strategy for the history optional. Before I delve into all of that, I would like to emphasize that the optional paper comprises of 500 marks out of a total of 1750 in the mains examination. So when you choose an optional, you have to be very careful. And don't just choose an optional because it's particularly scoring, because what might be scoring for others might not necessarily be scoring for you. So choose one that you can study for long hours and one which is easy for you to grasp. By grasping, I mean you enjoy reading the subject, you're able to understand the demands of the question, and you're able to answer the questions in a proper manner. I chose history as my optional because ever since my school days, I've enjoyed reading history and I've loved the subject. I pursued history at my graduation level as well, so it was but natural that I take this up as my optional subject. History also helps you in writing a good essay as well as in your GS1 paper, because a lot of the syllabus of GS1 overlaps with the history syllabus. So that's why if you consider these aspects too, history can be really beneficial for you if you choose it as an optional. At the same time, I would like to remind you all that history's syllabus is a little bit vast. So you have to be careful, you have to keep that in mind when you choose this subject as your optional. Students who haven't studied this subject at their school level or even at their college level, I would suggest it to them that they please study the old NCRTs as well as the new NCRTs to understand a basic background of the subject, and this will help you further when you go for in-depth readings. Once you are through with these basic texts, that is the old and the new NCRTs, I would suggest you go for the in-depth books. Now, these in-depth books include the following, and this is my basic book list that I followed when I was studying history as my option.
For UPSC CSE aspirants, current affairs are a very important part in the preparation. For this, you need to be updated with the day-to-day news, its detailing, and since the news is different every day, the task becomes time-consuming as well. For this, Unacademy has brought an easy and effective solution for the aspirants. What is it? The T20 Daily Current Affairs free test series, which will help you stay updated with the daily current affairs. The test series is conducted from Monday to Friday at 7:30 p.m. in which you will practice 20 latest current affair questions in 20 minutes with a detailed analysis provided by Unacademy's top educators Atish Mathur and Anand Agarwal. You will also get a detailed analysis of these tests in English and Hindi, and if you take the test live, you can check your rank as well. To enroll in the test series, click on the link mentioned in the description, download the Unacademy app, register on the app and select your goal UPSC CSE. Unlock the free test series, use our code and complete your test preparation with Unacademy. Let's crack it.
First and foremost, for ancient India, I refer to a history of ancient and early medieval India by Professor Rubinder Singh. For medieval India, I refer to medieval India by Satish Chandra. For modern India, I refer to From Plassey to Partition by Shekhar Bandyopadhyay. For world history, I refer to Norman Lo, Jain and Mathur, as well as selfstudyhistory.com's notes on world history. Thereafter, I had some supplementary sources as well. These included the IGNU BA notes as well as my own graduation notes. Here, I would like to sound a word of caution. When I recommend all these books, I don't mean to say that you have to read them from cover to cover. Rather, you should be focusing on selectively reading it so as to optimize your preparation. Now I'd like to discuss note making. Your own handwritten notes are extremely important for this option. So what you have to do is firstly, go through the syllabus on your own properly. If possible, kindly stick it on the wall wherever you're studying so that you can look at it again and again and refer to it time and again. Beyond that, I would also ask you to look at the past year question papers. Don't go beyond past five or six years. And then once you put these two together, you'll be able to understand the demand of the history optional and you'll be able to make your own handwritten notes properly. When you're basically making notes, I would suggest that you focus on historiography. Now, historiography is basically the study of writing of history, and history as a discipline has changed from being a simple narrative of the past. It now involves an understanding of and a critical analysis of the processes of continuity and change that have taken place in the sphere of economy, polity, society, etc. Therefore, your answer also needs to start reflecting that, and you should incorporate the viewpoints of the various historians that you will read when you're studying history as an option. and you should cite them wherever possible to add a sort of X factor to your answer and to make it stand out from the rest. While you're improving the quality of your answers, you can also cite archaeological and literary evidence. This again will show that you know you've done your readings and will impress the examiner and enable you to score really well in this paper. Another important aspect of history as an optional is map work. Now, if you're looking for a good source for maps, I would suggest you go through selfstudyhistory.com's collection of maps. They're quite comprehensive and they fulfill the demands of the UPSC examination. You should start practicing maps from the beginning of your preparation. Take about 30 minutes every day and mark 5 to 6 places on the map. And then write 30 to 40 words about each of these places. After you're done with the basic list, then you can go back to revising them whenever the exams are close by.
For UPSC CSE aspirants, current affairs are a very important part in the preparation. For this, you need to be updated with the day-to-day news, its detailing, and since the news is different every day, the task becomes time-consuming as well. For this, An Academy has brought an easy and effective solution for the aspirants. What is it? The T20 Daily Current Affairs free test series, which will help you stay updated with the daily current affairs. The test series is conducted from Monday to Friday at 7:30 p.m. in which you will practice 20 latest current affair questions in 20 minutes with a detailed analysis provided by An Academy's top educators Atish Mathur and Anand Agarwal. You will also get a detailed analysis of these tests in English and Hindi, and if you take the test live, you can check your rank as well. To enroll in the test series, click on the link mentioned in the description, download the An Academy app, register on the app and select your goal UPSC CSE. Unlock the free test series, use our code and complete your test preparation with An Academy. Let's crack it.
After this, I'd like to move on to answer writing. So once you're through with the syllabus, I would suggest you begin answer writing practice. If you want, you can begin answer writing practice at home itself. There are a lot of compilations of past year papers that are available and you can refer to them and begin practicing answers, writing them at home. Once you feel a little more confident of yourself, then you can go for test series. I took up two test series for history optional, one from GS Core and another from selfstudyhistory.com. Taking at least two test series for your optional or for any other paper, for instance your mains as well as your prelims, is extremely important because you understand the kind of questions that UPSC can ask as well as the wide variety of questions that can be asked in your paper. This will prepare you to tackle the questions when you face them in an examination setting. So that was my basic strategy for history as an optional. Feel free to pick or discard aspects of my strategy according to your needs. And you can even reach out to me on Quora or Instagram. I'm available and I would respond to your queries as far as possible and as soon as I can. I have a blog as well where I've detailed various aspects of my preparation strategy. And that's all for me. Best wishes to you all and stay tuned to Delhi Knowledge Track.